Nobody makes a monkey out of Kid Tannen! Ow! Fix me up!
Coefficient of friction remains constant in the gravitation. So constant is variable.
Don't think, Emmett, think. H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A. H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A.
Is reduced by the inverse of the derivative of the speed relative to the speed of light.
Psst, Doc! So, Doc, does this ring a bell?
Oh, think, Emmett, think! H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A. H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A.
Good grief! Is that me? I sound so...
young?
I was gonna say intense. I forgot how wound up I used to get.
Yeah, but what are you muttering about?
Oh, that's easy. It's Ivanov's conundrum. Just tell my younger self that H equals the Hamiltonian operator.
Won't giving him the answer mess up the time stream?
Only if it turns out that reality is actually nothing more than a holographic illusion created by the interplay of subatomic particles on a vast two-dimensional membrane.
So...
it'll be fine.
Hang in there, Doc.
Is that even possible?
Oh, let's start over.
Come on, wait up a minute.
You again? Can't you see I'm busy?
Maybe H equals the Hamiltonian operator.
What did you just say?
I said maybe H equals the...
Hamiltonian operator?
Yeah!
Great Scott! If H is a Hamiltonian, then H to the A multiplied by the inverse of H can only be the same as the expectation value for A! Ha ha! That's it! That's the solution to Ivanov's conundrum, the problem I've been wrestling with in my head all week!
I'm sure you would have figured it out by yourself in a day or two. The way you figured out how to build that rocket-powered drill.
Where did you learn so much about science?
Well, it's like this.
You know about my rocket-powered drill? Then there can only be one explanation.
What?
You're from the patent office! I confess I didn't quite know what to expect when I sent the paperwork, but I never expected this. Welcome! I'm at your service. What can I do for you?
Can I see your rocket-powered drill?
Of course, of course! Naturally, it's just a scale model, but it's nearly operational. I can show it to you, say, first thing in the morning?
Nah, that's no good. I need to see a full-size model. That's fully operational.
Whoa!
Tonight. Otherwise, we'll have to award the patent to a competing inventor, Dr. McCoy.
It can't be done! I mean, it might be possible to construct a full-size working model in that time frame, but I haven't got the main ingredient for the fuel!
I'll get it for you. What is it?
190-proof grain alcohol! And you know how difficult it is to get a hold of alcohol these days.
Especially now that someone's blown up the speakeasy.
And besides, there's no way I can get off work until I've delivered this subpoena. Part of the investigation into the business affairs of Kid Tannen. Is it vitally important you see that rocket-powered drill today?
Yes. Is it vitally important you deliver that subpoena today?
Yes!
Listen, I'll help you deliver it, and I'll see to it you get the alcohol you need. It'll help you get that drill finished by tonight. Deal?
Deal. Here's the subpoena.
I've got a subpoena my grandpa.
No! It's Kid Tannen!
Hey, I just saw him at the soup kitchen yelling at Arthur McFly.
I'm not surprised. Arthur does the books for his business.
What kind of business?
That's what the DA is trying to find out.
Let's go talk to him.
No!
Why not? Kid Tannen can tell us where Arthur's hiding.
Yeah, well, he can also have us fitted for a Chicago overcoat.
The hell, Matches? You got kiwi all over my socks!
Sorry, boss.
Get out of here! How about you? Huh? I'm sitting at a shoe shine booth. You walk up. Either you're here to shine my shoes, or you got a death wish. Which is it? I'm looking for a guy named Arthur McFly. He's my, sort of a relative. Well, he's my employee. He's very busy today. Since you're Arthur's boss, you know where he is, right?
He's at the, office.
Where's the office?
I forget.
So when do you think Arthur will be leaving the office?
When I tell him he can leave the office.
Hey, you missed a spot.
Isn't that Arthur McFly's hat you're holding?
It was McFly's hat. Now, it's my peanut ball.
Could I buy Arthur's hat off you?
Could you keep your mind on your work, huh? Shoeshine boy? Hanging on to my peanut ball.
Can I have some peanuts?
Why not? I'm a magnanimous kind of guy. Go ahead, knock yourself out.
Hey, kid!
Yeah?
What the hell is that?
Hey!
What'd you do?
Give me that hat, you lousy crook!
Emmett!
A monkey out of Kid Tannen! Ow! Fix me up!
Where'd you learn how to move like that?
Sandlot football. They used to call me the Streak.
Get out! Come here for a sec, boy. Hey, boy, can you find the guy who belongs to this hat?
Where's he going?
Only one way to find out. Huh, deja vu.
Yeah? Who is it?
It's McFly!
Shh, I know! Hey, Arthur, can you come down a minute?
Do I know you?
I'm your mother's great-nephew.
You mean my second cousin?
Yeah.
Glad to know you, but I can't leave this building till the boss says so. He's given strict orders. Sorry. Some other time. What now?
It's me again. Please come down.
Why?
We've got something for you.
It's a sub...
A subscription to the Accountant Weekly. He won't come out if he knows why we're really here.
No, right.
I'm not interested. And besides, the boss won't let me leave the room. Sorry, some other time. What now?
It's me again. Please come down.
Why?
We represent the law.
You don't want to go against the law, do you?
No, but I don't want to go against Kid Tannen either. And he ordered me to stay put till he gives the word. Sorry, some other time.
Well, well, look who's back! They say rats always return to the scene of the sinking ship. Get him, Matches! From there, you son of a bitch! Right now! That's an order! Don't make... What do you think you're doing up there, you scrawny little runt? Get down here right now! You can't...
Einstein! Help!
Get away, crazy mutt. Go away, dog.
We're busy here. Go on, scram. Hey, where'd he go?
You let him get away, idiot.
What now?
What do you think you're doing up there, you scrawny little runt? Get down here right now!
It's Kid! Right away, boss! Where's Kid?
Arthur McFly?
Yeah?
Got something for you.
Thanks. A subpoena?
Ordering you to appear in court and provide evidence in the investigation into—
Kid Tannen? Take it back!
You can't get rid of it, Mr. McFly. Once you've been served, it's your duty to report to the court at the earliest possible time. Failure to do so could lead to a warrant for your arrest.
Arrest? But Kid'll kill me. Stupid, stupid Artie. Holy cats, what am I gonna do?
I suggest you avail yourself to the protection of the court.
Oh gosh, oh gosh.
Oh, I hate doing stuff like that. But I won't have to much longer.
No?
Once we get that 190-proof alcohol and build my rocket drill, my future will be set and I'll be able to quit this crummy job.
Oh, right. How about Kid Tannen? What do we know about him?
He's loud, he's obnoxious, he's not very bright, and he doesn't like anybody getting in his way.
Yep, that's a Tannen, all right. This might be a stupid question, but couldn't you have designed your rocket-powered drill to run on fuel that, you know, isn't illegal?
Illegal? What does law have to do with science? Science has its own laws. You of all people should know that.
But couldn't you tweak your engine design a little so it runs on something else?
Like what?
I don't know. Gas, maybe?
Gasoline? Yesterday's news. You'll see. By 1940, automobiles will all run on pure alcohol.
Some of us down at the patent office are wondering, what made you think of a rocket-powered drill?
Ah, that'd be Journey to the Center of the Earth by Jules Verne. It was a revelation.
Yeah, that's kind of what we figured. Have you read The Time Machine?
H.G. Wells? Not yet, but it's on my list.
We'll score that hooch somehow.
I'll keep cogitating.
Hey, Miss Strickland.
Oh, hello, Mr. Crockett. Try not to draw any undue attention my way. I'm on the trail of a hot new scoop, as we in the newspaper business say.
What's the scoop?
I've heard rumors that something shady is going on at the Sisters of Mercy soup kitchen. It's under new management, you know. And, oh, we mustn't jump to any conclusions, not till the facts are in. I hope to heaven it is just a rumor. That soup kitchen is the front line in the good fight. If it goes bad, what will happen to the Stay Sober Society? Not to mention all the charitable institutions that depend on me for soup deliveries.
You make hot soup deliveries?
It's one of my many small contributions to the good cause. Healthy bodies, healthy souls, or so one hopes. I pick up barrels of hot soup at the kitchen, and I deliver them hither and thither. Hill Valley Orphanage, the St. Francis Xavier Ranch for Unwanted Children, Foggy Mountain Home for the Incurably Insane, Shady Acres Rest Home. Oh, I can barely keep track of them all. It's a very big job.
What's the Stay Sober Society?
You haven't heard of the SSS? They do the most marvelous work, taking hopeless drunken bums and turning them into former hopeless drunken bums. I'm one of the founding members. And not to say that I was ever, well, you know. Anyway, we've always met in the cellar of the Sisters of Mercy soup kitchen, but for some reason the new managers don't want us down there, so we're stuck. We've got nowhere to meet.
Did you finish the story you interviewed me for? About Carl Sagan?
Yes, but those pig-headed editors at the paper rejected it. They said my story was slanted, and that I was glorifying a suspected arsonist. As if their stories aren't always glorifying the criminal vermin that run this town. This whole thing makes me so mad I could spit! Though of course I never would. There's an ordinance against it, and it's so untidy.
Hey, I can help you deliver soup. I donate a lot of time to charities.
Oh? Which ones?
The, Mario Brothers.
Ah, yes. The Italians do so many good works.
If you'll just fix it so I can pick up the barrels of soup.
Now hold your horses, let's not get overeager. I drive the soup cycle in this town, and I'm not about to turn it over to an upstart. But if you're well-connected with the local charitable institutions...
Yeah?
You can let me know when they're running low on soup.
As a matter of fact, I do know a local charity that's running low on soup.
Oh? Who?
The Stay Sober Society.
Yes, we do generally provide refreshments for the Stay Sober Society, but I'm afraid they may not be able to meet tonight. They haven't got a meeting space.
I know a place where the Stay Sober Society can meet.
Oh? Where?
The Brown Residence.
You mean Judge Brown's place?
Yeah, I happen to be good friends with his son Emmett, and he's told me the judge would love to lend his place out for, you know, good causes like yours.
Really? Why, that's the most generous, public-spirited offer I've received in a month of Sundays. Please, tell your friend Emmett we accept. The meeting isn't due to start for a little while, so that'll give our people some time to set up.
You asked me to tell you if one of the local charities is running low on soup.
Does somebody need a visit for my soup cycle?
The Stay Sober Society.
Bless you for thinking of them. But that meeting isn't scheduled to start for a little while. And we wouldn't want them eating cold soup.
I got a book.
Oh? Where?